Hello, beloved St. Columbus community. It's good to be back in town after most of the summer away in cooler climes. But returning to pandemic world here and the political frenzy of these strange times, I think about where to dig in spiritually and how to grow and flourish rather than worry and fume. In this morning's Washington Post, I read an op-ed column about stoicism as a fine-tuned awareness of all that is beyond our control, and those few but important things that are in our control, i.e. our own thoughts and actions. This is a reassuring philosophy in the abstract, but often so hard to actually live out, particularly when we face anger and conflict and the need for forgiveness. Looking ahead to this Sunday's gospel reading, I found it to be one of Jesus' hardest teachings about forgiveness, directing us to forgive unconditionally, 70 times 7, and that as we are forgiven by God, we too must show mercy and forgiveness to others. But is forgiveness an action or a behavior that we can control or not? I can't just will myself to forgive someone. Can't just say the words and have them be true. There is so much these days that can make us angry. Even small things can set me off, perhaps because the big picture, virus and protests and extreme climate change and just so much hypocrisy and dishonesty form such a dispiriting backdrop for our daily lives. I think we need help with forgiveness, and I think we often get it. I think that forgiveness often comes as a gift of grace, something we didn't think we could find in ourselves until it happens. So here's a really tiny example. A couple of days ago, I was enraged by repeated calls from an electricity supplier. The caller was mostly incomprehensible and had a script of repetitious questions and would answer none of mine. When I finally got off the line, I was just furious, snapped at Bill, and rushed out the door to walk the dog. It was as if I could walk off my outrage at top speed. But halfway up the street, I encountered a young couple and their little toddler girl, and they were blowing bubbles. And as a cloud of the bubbles flowed up and out and around the little girl, she lifted her arms out and said, "Oh, oh," and laughed. She was so thrilled. Such a sweet moment. But it brought me back to myself and to a world beyond my recent upset. I felt my anger fade. I experienced forgiveness about the whole stupid phone business. Forgiveness, not as something I'd conjured up, but simply as release. I was able to let go and continue my walk with a fresher, lighter mood. And I just felt thankful for the girl, her parents, and for the bubbles. This little story doesn't engage the hardest issues around forgiveness and repentance because I wasn't in conflict with the particular person who had wronged me. I didn't need to consider another's willingness to be sorry or to change. All it did was remind me of wonder and delight. I felt forgiven for my truculence, but I also felt forgiving of the annoying caller, who was after all only doing a boring, low-paying job, forcing her to listen to people like me all day long. As we seek to be loving towards ourselves and others, let's recognize that forgiveness is neither totally beyond nor within our control. I do believe it's one way that God's love moves through us as we seek to forgive, and I give thanks to God at those times, great or small, when I can. Amen.